The other comment I would like to make about this is, we don't know if Saudi Arabia was involved in these attacks. I don't know, at least. But what I know for sure is that Saudi Arabia is and was involved in terrorist attacks in Iraq, in Syria, in Afghanistan, in Pakistan, in Yemen, in Bahrain, in Lebanon. Many terrorist attacks took place in these countries. Thousands of innocent people have been killed by Saudi-inspired terrorists. And Saudi has never been held accountable for these crimes. Indeed, always Saudis receive a rain check for what they do. And they get a free ride for what they do. And they have never been held accountable for the many crimes committed by their agents, by their financed terrorists, by people who received aids, whether from the government of Saudi directly or from financiers and wealthy men and women in Saudi Arabia. No one talked about their role so far, because Saudi Arabia have been shielded through its alliance with the United States. And that gave Saudi Arabia immunity for so many years, for decades, by not allowing anybody to speak about their role. And if there is any attempt by any entity to expose their role, Saudi Arabia is very quick to intimidate others, just like they did with the United Nations. When the United Nations was about to launch an inquiry about their crimes, Saudi crimes in Yemen, what did the Saudis do? They immediately threatened that they will hold any aid, financial aid, from the United Nations. And Ban Ki-moon decided to stop the inquiry and not to go after Saudi Arabia, because Saudi Arabia has so much money and they can bribe any person, including Mr. Ban Ki-moon.